Hello all and welcome to video classes by Conroe Institutes. Today we will be discussing what are the textbooks which are being prescribed by the NCERT for the PUC first year. Okay, so in the economics subject they have prescribed two textbooks, wherein we have these two textbooks. Okay, one is the Indian Economic Development and another is the Statistics for Economics. So, this textbook, the Indian Economic Development, here in this, if you have 10 chapters, okay, and in the Statistics for Economics, you have 9 chapters. This textbook is all about the theoretical part, wherein we will be understanding how the India has been developing its economy, okay, and whereas the second textbook which is being prescribed by the NCERT, that is Statistics for Economics. In this, you will be studying stats, okay? Basic statistics how the data needs to be collected, how it needs to be organized, what is the presentation, how the data needs to be presented, and how we have to interpret those data and how we have to come to a conclusion. And also it tells about how to use these statistical tools and all. So this is more kind of mathematics where you can enjoy this class. And this is the first Indian Economic Development. This is more of the theoretical part where you will be understanding how the Indian economy was before and how it is now. And what will be the plans to make the economic development more progressive, these will be seen, or these can be taught under this chapter. So if we just go on reading the chapter names from the Indian Economic Development, we have something called as Indian Economy on the Eve of Independence. You can see that they have given main topics, and in that chapter, or you can say in that main chapter, there will be sub chapters. Okay, so including all these, you will have 10 chapters. Okay, so, and then we have Indian economy from 1950 to 1990, wherein we can study how the Indian economy was during that period from 1950 to 1990. And then next we have liberalization, privatization, and globalization. This also comes under economics, right? So we will be studying how the liberalization took place and what are the benefits of the globalization, what kind of globalization factors are affecting the Indian economic development and all. We will be studying under this chapter. Next we have poverty. Yes, so when we are talking about or when we are studying the economics, we are not studying economics of a small region, right? We will be studying economics as a whole, right? So when we are studying economics under this, the name itself is indicating, right? Indian Economic Development. So here the poverty chapter talks about the Indian poverty. So what are the reasons or how we can eradicate the poverty which we are seeing in our country, right? Next we have human capital formation in India, right? Human capital, you all know, right? Human resource we call it as, right? Or we even call it as a population, right? So in this human capital formation, what we understand or what we study is how the human capital needs to be transformed it as one of the biggest capital for our nation. Capital, you know, right, which comes under the accountancy term, right? Capital which helps us to commence a business, right? So here we are talking about the human capital, that means human resource as transferred as the capital, right? So here we will be understanding the employment ratio, literacy ratio and all. And next we have something called as a rural development. If you take the quote which is being given by the Mahatma Gandhi, he talks about this rural development, right? Rural development, if we progress this rural development, then we will be called as the developed countries, or we will be considered in that one of the developed countries, right? So in this rural development, we talk about the giving prioritizing for the laborers which are available for us in the rural areas, or shifting of the factories in the rural areas so that we can give them the employment opportunity. So it talks about creating employment to the rural people, okay, and even providing them the basic amenities which are being prescribed by the government. So these all comes under the rural development. Next, we have employment growth information and other issues. So employment itself talks about the creating the employment, right? So employment gives us the earning of our living, right? So if we don't have a proper employment, then how are we going to lead our life, or how are we going to earn for our living, right? So this all we can talk under this chapter. And next we have infrastructure. So infrastructure is nothing but the buildings, what we can say, or the materials so that we can run a institution or a firm, right? So hospital is also an infrastructure, and the institution buildings is also infrastructure. So if we have a good infrastructure in our country, what happens? We can achieve the goal, or we can achieve the target, right? Even the road construction, which are building the link between the villages and the cities, right? If we don't have this infrastructure, the road infrastructure, then can we able to connect these two cities or two areas? No, right? So we need that roads and all. So this infrastructure talks about how much importance we have of the infrastructures. So we have different kinds of infrastructures. So that will be under this chapter. And next we have environment and sustainable development. So how the environment we have, or how we need to be created, and what is this sustainable development? Sustainable development is that when we have created an environment, right? So that we have to keep it for a long duration, right? So we are sustaining that kind of environment. So if we have to sustain, then we have to make certain progresses. We have to make a continuous progress so that we can make that environment into a sustainable development. Okay, so that comes under the environment and the sustainable development. And next we have a comparative development experiences of India and its neighboring countries. Okay, so here we will be talking about India with comparison to the neighboring countries which we have. Okay, and then we will be even talking about how we need to build the relationship between the neighboring countries so that the trade, the foreign exchange trade, or the foreign trade what we are carrying out with the neighboring countries, that will be more effective. Okay, so that comes under this chapter. And moving to the second textbook, which has been prescribed by the NCERT, that is Statistics for Economics. Here we have 9 chapters. Okay, first chapter talks about the introduction, wherein why we need statistics for economics, or why we have to study economics, and what are the advantages or disadvantages of studying statistics, right? So that all talks about statistics in general in the first chapter. And in the next chapter we have something called as the collection of data. So the name itself is telling, right? Collection of data. How are we supposed to collect the data, right? These all features, or all the rules and regulations, how we need to collect the data is been discussed under this chapter. And next we have organization of data. Once we have collected the data, then we have to organize that, right? We cannot just go collect and then we arrive to an conclusion, right? So that's the reason we have to organize that data. So there are so many procedures wherein we can organize these data. That's what we can understand under this chapter. And next, the presentation of data. So we have a graph to look at, we have tables, right, when it comes to statistics. So those all things we will be studying under this chapter, under the presentation of data. And next we have measures of central tendency, measures of dispersion, So this here in these two chapters, it will be more like a calculation wherein whatever the data you have been collected and also you have organized and presented, how are you going to come to an conclusion, right? You have to come to a conclusion. On what basis are you going to come to a conclusion? So here are some of the formulas, calculations, wherein you will be doing, and the product, whatever you are getting from out of this problem or out of this formulas, that with that you are going to conclude the survey or the data which you have collected. And next we have a correlation. Okay, so correlation is something wherein you will be talking about two variables. Okay, for example, if I am talking about the online classes, and if you compare with your previous classes, how it used to be in the class wherein you will be interacting with your teachers. So if you compare that kind of environment wherein you will be interacting with your teachers directly, and now the situation has changed, right? Now there is no interaction, only you just have to watch the videos. And then if you have any of the queries, what do you have to do? You have to reach to your teachers, right? Through a phone, or you have to come down to the college for clarifying your doubts. So when you compare this kind of classes to the previous kind of classes wherein you have already studied, so what is your opinion, right? So you can make that comparison, right? So that's what we, that kind of situation we understand under the correlation, right? Next we have an index number. So in this index number we have several kind of index number. For example, if I want to mention here is consumer price index number, we have weighted price index number, right? So here in this chapter you will have a different kind of formulas wherein you have to calculate these index numbers. And in the last chapter, which is a use of statistical tools, as I have mentioned earlier, in this chapter you will be understanding how the statistical tools are used to come to a conclusion. So here you have some kind of topics wherein you will be creating a survey, or where you will be developing a survey, and then with that the data you have to collect, and then you have to follow those all the procedures which I have mentioned earlier: collecting of the data, organizing of the data, presenting, and then interpreting, right? So these all the things you will study under this chapter. It's not that big, but it's just a brief summary of what you all have studied. So this is all about what you will get in the statistics. So in the question paper you will have a proportion of both this, the Indian, the economic development, and the statisticals for economics. This economics chapter for you in the PUC is like a scoring subject, wherein you have statistics, right? So you don't have to just go on writing the theoretical part. So you have then a good opportunity so that you can score more in your economics. But that's not the same part for the second PUC economics. You have two, even there you have two textbooks, but it's all about microeconomics and macroeconomics. So we will look into that in the next year, but this is what we have in the first year PUC economics. So I hope you all have received your textbooks. If not, even you can download these textbooks from the website pue.kar.ne, which is a PU Pre-University Education Board website, wherein you can download all kind of textbooks, not just the economics. Even you can download business studies, accountancy, English, or Kannada and Hindi if you have opted for. And you even get the Kannada medium versions there, and even you get the question bank. So it's all about what we have, or what is necessary for the first PUC. So you will get there. If at all you won't be able to download, you can even Google some of the textbooks. Even you can order from online, and you can refer from your mobile. Okay, see you all in the next video, more on the first chapter from the statistics of economics.